I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hi, Tracy students. This is Ms. Mejia. I'm the new Tracy High School counselor, and I'm very excited to be here. A little bit about myself. I grew up in the San Fernando Valley. I have three kids. I have a 20-year-old, a 14-year-old, and an 8-month-old. Some of my hobbies include basically anything to do outdoors. I love hiking. I love swimming in the lakes. I love camping. I love being at the beach. I love the beach. Horseback riding, fishing. So anything that has to do with being adventurous and being outdoors, I basically love. So I'm very excited to be here. And my role here as a counselor is to basically really get you guys to graduate, to go to college, to whatever it is that your goal is in life, I'm here to get you from here to wherever that is. So I'm very excited to be here and to get you guys ready for either college or your careers. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to come by my office or reach out, and I'll be more than happy to help you guys.
Starting Christmas Day, the Staples Center will be renamed to the Crypto.com Arena after they paid $700 million for naming rights. According to ABC7 LA, the Staples Center will become known as Crypto.com Arena as a part of a 20-year deal between the Singapore Cryptocurrency Exchange and AEG, owner of the home arena of the Lakers, Clippers, Kings, and Sparks. The arena's new logo will debut December 25th when the Lakers host the Brooklyn Nets, and all of the Staples Center signage will be replaced with a new name by June 2022.
Hello Saints, it's Jose, and today we're going to be talking about the unreleased Air Jordan 11 Cool Grays that dropped this December 11th. They are re-releasing the iconic gray-on-gray colorway that is sought after by many Jordan collectors and shoe lovers. For a chance to win these, make sure you join some shoe raffles or hop on the sneakers app. Don't sleep, these will for sure sell out and go up in prices. For an extra chance, make sure you follow my IG, @2CoKicks, for any updates or pairs in your size.
Sleep, a beautiful thing. It helps people retain information, perform better on memory tasks, restore and rejuvenate, grow muscle, repair tissue, and synthesize hormones. Studies have even shown that a good amount of sleep could put you in a good mood for the day. Sleep is an amazing thing that you just don't want to pass up, and although it can get bad sometimes with nightmares and etc., it can also be good with dreams and etc. The craziest and most amazing part about sleep, though, has to be deja vu and lucid dreaming. The reason why is simple, is because deja vu is literally you seeing an event that's going to happen before it happens, while lucid dreaming is basically you living in your imagination realistically. With all this info, I hope you see how great sleep is.
Frigid conditions in Edmonton were one of the main talking points during Canada's 2-1 World Cup qualifying win over Mexico on Tuesday. Temperatures dipped as low as 14 degrees with the wind chill. Chilly conditions felt like 5 degrees. At Commonwealth Stadium, making it the coldest game on record for El Tri. According to multiple sources, though, the snow flurries pounded the area just hours before the game. Conditions cleared up in time for kickoff, allowing for the field launch for the CFL's Edmonton Elks, who shared a stadium to be seen. The visit to Canada wrapped up on an icy road trip for a trio as the team faced the United States in Cincinnati on Friday, and the game played mostly in the low 40s. Much like the weather itself, Mexico cooled off after a hot start to the qualifying, losing both to Canada, to the U.S. men's team and Canada.
Hello, Saints. It's time for Saints Spotlight. Saints Spotlight is exactly what the name says. It highlights one of our students and provides us the opportunity to learn something special and unique about them. Saints Spotlight is part of our weekly KTHS Morning Spotlight, and one special thing about this is that Mr. Brown will post this on our social media pages, our school website, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Here at Tracy, we love to recognize our Saints here who are doing great things. And our Saints Spotlight winner is Dulce Ordonez. She's 10th grade, went to Hawaiian Elementary School, Winnie Middle School, and Winnie High School. She'll return to Winnie next fall and plans to attend New York University after graduating and major in business administration.
Okay. Good morning, Saints. It's time for Money Monday, and we have a lucky winner today. Remember, every Saints is eligible to be a Money Monday winner. All you have to do is have perfect attendance for the previous week and you will have your name selected at random by Mr. Brown. That's all it takes. The Money Monday winner for today is Freddie Hymas. Freddie is in 11th grade. He went to Melbourne Elementary School, Fetty Middle School, Artesia High School, and he will graduate with the Tracy Class of 2023. He will become a welder after high school, and his long-term career goal is to be a social media influencer with an emphasis on gaming content. Congratulations, Freddie. Mr. Brown will be getting in touch with you soon for a nice prize, and you will also be featured on our Tracy social media, Facebook, and Instagram pages. And as always, go Saints! Stay in the city, breaking and everybody.